and of the household of God. Now, built upon the foundation of apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone, in whom all the building fitly framed together grow into a holy temple in the Lord. So here Paul is clearly pointing out to us, stop acting like strangers, like you're not entitled to the best of the best. God said, he told him over there, let some of that good stuff get in her path, and don't rebuke her for picking it up. Yeah, or sometimes Sister Hill will roll up there in a Bentley next week. Automobile. You should. Oh, no. 46th Street. She's driving a Bentley. Oh. But the question still remains: is she entitled to it? But there'll be where our mindsets is not wrapped around the fact that you are not prohibited. You had a question, Kim.
Oh, I didn't really have a plan. Verse 18, not only did she bring back the barley that she had gleaned, but it says that she had given her that which she had reserved after she was sufficed. Mm-hmm. When he had fed her, there was so much left over that she had to bring back. And that's when you're operating in faith, the blessings that will come will be more than enough for you.
More than enough for you. More than enough.
So, that is your responsibility to share.
So Ruth knew, she discovered, as he says, as you are coming to trust in the God of Israel, she was getting more and more revelation as to what she was entitled to, though she didn't own it, but as she went out, it started coming to her. See, if you don't think you're entitled to be well, wellness, help, that favor, that grace won't even bother you. Oops. If you think you're not entitled to have resources or money won't come. You're gonna, you better go through the Iowa camp. Something be cool. It's better if you, money won't even. Yeah. Why bother with that person? They don't even understand. Oh, it's better if we see growth and ugly and everything else. The favor won't even show up for you. But if you have the attitude and the knowledge that, yes, God is making those provisions, I have the right, I've been bought and purchased, all paid for through the redemptive process of Jesus Christ, stuff will start happening your way. But if you are the resistant element, it is never going to come in here because you're pushing it all the way. Here's Ruth, I'm entitled to it, I'm learning about all this stuff, but here's my circumstance, I'm stepping out in faith, just doing this, doing that, and then favor and grace come her way. And then she gets the ultimate blessing when they find out we're going to find it. What was the ultimate blessing?
She's part of the lineage.
She's part of the lineage. She can see, now it ain't just in my head, it's in the paper.
I like the way the writer in the lesson, the Bowman text eliminated, and how he explained it. It says, the first thing we notice from the preceding context is that Boaz's statement expressed in the form of a prayerful wish of affirmation was a response to Ruth's attitude of deep humility. Mm-hmm. Boaz had just gone out of his way to show special kindness to her, and she found that to be astonishing in the light of her lowly position as a stranger. Mm-hmm. Boaz, however, saw her heart, and he had heard of her devotion to Naomi, and how that devotion had led her to give up everything she once knew and follow her into potential hardship and suffering. He did not want that sacrifice to go unnoticed. Mm-hmm. And he was confident that it would not. The Lord recompense thy work, and a full reward be given thee. It is interesting that the Hebrew word for recompense is built on the word for peace. It means to make good or to pay. But there is an underlying idea of God making things whole or at peace through his reward. More important than her devotion to Naomi, Boaz correctly discerned Ruth's faith in God. Her real reward would not be found in Boaz's few acts of kindness. It would come from the Lord God of Israel, under whose wings thou art come to trust. This was a picturesque way of affirming that Ruth had put her full faith and trust and protect in the protective and saving power of God. She may have been raised a heathen, But God had made her one of his very own.
Yes. Hallelujah. That's dancing.
That is dancing.
I mean, I'm kind of a heathen background, but look what the Lord is doing. All right, that's going to conclude our lesson.
We'll take the box right back down.